Welcome back to Accessible Gourmet. Today we're making hot pot. We're going to need 1 tablespoon of neutral oil, 1 cinnamon stick, 5 dried chilies, 1/2 tablespoon of Szechuan peppercorns, 5 anise seeds, 5 whole cloves, 2 bay leaves, 4 slices of ginger, 5 cloves of garlic, as well as 7 cups of the broth of your choice, and a hot pot soup base. You can definitely make soup base from scratch. I don't know how to, since I've never made hot pot before, so I decided to go with this kit I got on Amazon. So for medium heat, we're gonna heat up the oil and stir fry our ginger for 1 minute. And then we're gonna add the cinnamon stick, bay leaves, star anise, cloves, as well as our garlic, and let this cook for 2 more minutes. After 2 minutes, we're gonna add in our Szechuan peppercorn and our dried chilies, as well as our hot pot soup base. So this is basically, one pouch has the powdered bouillon, the second pouch has a bunch of dried chilies since I opted for the spicy soup base. It also comes with a pouch of hot oil and a tiny pouch of fermented black beans. We're gonna stir this around and make sure everything is well incorporated until it forms kind of a paste. And then we're gonna let this cook for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, we're gonna add in all of our broth and bring this whole mixture up to a boil and then lower to a simmer, because we need to keep this hot until we transfer to whatever pot that we're using to form our hot pot. As far as the soup components for this dish, you can choose whatever you like. If you're vegetarian, you can keep your options vegetarian. I am opting for these ingredients. So I am slicing a ribeye as thin as possible. To aid in getting this as thin as possible, you want a very sharp knife and you want your protein to be semi-frozen. I wanted to try out this knife from a company called Mercer for a while. My partner does web development for them, so I ordered one online. This isn't sponsored. I was just curious about the products that they had, and I was really, really pleased with the performance of this knife. So if you're looking for a new knife, this one is a good one. I also thinly sliced up some pork belly. And we're just gonna cut these as thin as possible and set them aside on trays until we're ready to cook them in the soup. And then you usually have fish cake in hot pot, but I didn't have any fish cake, or I couldn't find any. So I just opted to chop up this faux crab into chunks as a replacement for the fish cakes. I also usually always have homemade dumplings on hand, but I was out. So I am going to use these frozen pre-made ones that we got at Wegmans. We also need some noodles. I had these glass noodles. I know you should probably use more ramen style noodles, but this is what I had in my pantry, as well as some rice cakes. Then I had this great Japanese eggplant that I got in my Asian veggies grocery delivery, and I just chopped these up into chunks. I like Japanese eggplant because they're not as bitter as the bulb eggplant, the Italian one. But yeah, so I chopped these up into chunks and put them on the tray. Then I'm using whatever greens I had on hand. I had some Chinese broccoli. I also had some Chinese mustard greens. So I just chopped these up, removed any of the yellow leaves. I know these pieces seem kind of big, but they are going to wilt in the soup. I also have a little baby bok choy, well, a whole bok choy. I wanted baby bok choy, but my grocery is out, so I don't know why I only ordered one, but I did. But this should be enough for the soup. I also have some napa cabbage. I'm just pulling off any of the leaves that are a little browned. And then pulling off some large leaves. I'm gonna chop these up into chunks because again, these are gonna wilt also in the hot soup. I just took off the bottom core and the middle rib. I'm also using some enoki mushrooms, as well as some shiitakes. In a lot of these hot pot videos, I've noticed that most of the cooks cut a little cross in the top, and I know there's a purpose for that, but I just opted to chop these in half instead. Also tofu, just cut these up into chunks. I'm using a firm tofu. Some people prefer soft, but I like firm tofu. Now we're moving on to the dipping sauce, and I have one scallion that I'm going to chop up and put in a small bowl. As well as the leaves of 4 stems of cilantro. Give this a rough chop and put it in the bowl. And I'm adding some soy sauce. Oh, that was black vinegar. Some black vinegar, some soy sauce, some sesame oil, as well as my homemade chili oil. You can use whatever ingredients you want in your dipping sauce. If you just like soy and black vinegar, do that. And I don't really measure anything. This is all kind of by taste. And that's all the components for the soup. I did not have a hot pot or a butane stove, so I have this fondue pot that my friend Amanda gifted me. So I turned it on ahead of time, and I'm carefully putting the broth into my fondue pot. Just be careful not to spill it, because this soup is hot since it's been on the stove, and I'm turning up the heat on this because we want this to be a low boil or a simmer. Then we just start adding in our ingredients. I put the noodles in first, the rice cakes, because those take a little longer to cook, some dumplings, and ideally you would sit around the table and people would pick from the trays and cook what they wanted to eat in the broth. I'm just dumping this all in here because it's just the two of us and we're gonna eat it regardless. So in go the greens and the cabbage. Eggplant. The eggplant turned out to be amazing in this. Adding some mushrooms. And last but not least, I'm adding in the proteins. These tend to cook the fastest, so that's why I opted to put these in last. Oh, and the tofu. And these all simmer in this delicious spicy broth. If you notice the broth getting too low, just add more water. And then I called the partner over and we feasted for New Year's Eve. This was delightful to make. It was really delicious, spicy as all get out, but it was so good that we couldn't stop eating it. And there it is, my version of an Asian hot pot. I hope you try to make it. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, click the like button. If you loved it, subscribe and click the notification bell because I put out new videos every week. Until next time, happy cooking.